Rupa and I created the Superlist block, and this is a little overview slash tutorial on how to use the block. So let's get started. Okay, so here I have a install of WordPress 5.9, and that is the minimum version you need in order to be able to use the Superlist block. Let's go ahead and install it. Okay, so when you are installing the plugin, from the plugin directory, the easiest way to find it is to put Superlist in double quotes. And there it is. That's what it looks like. I'm just going to go ahead and install and activate it. Okay, so it's activated. Now let's go ahead and open up a brand new page and play with it. Okay, so you can add it any way you would add a block normally. So that could be from the block library on the side. You'll notice it's inside the design area, or of course by just pressing slash over here and searching for it like so and pressing enter. So once you add the block, right away you're going to notice there are two bullet points added for you right away, and there is a big prominent button, add superlist item, that lets you add another list item, so in this case another bullet point, to the block. So if I click it, you'll see it adds a third bullet point in this case, and it focuses it so you can start adding things to it. But let's go back to the very first one. So the superpower of Superlist is that inside each list item, so inside each bullet item at the moment, you can add as many blocks as you want and whatever blocks you want. There's no limit to what you can add. So let's say I want to create sort of a list of images with headings, okay? So I'm just going to press slash here, I'm going to type in image, and then I can choose an image from the media library, like so. And if I press enter after the image, you'll notice that you're still inside that first bullet point. It hasn't gone to the second one. You can still keep adding more items, more blocks to the current list item. This is a game changer. So I'm just going to add a heading. This is my first list item. Then I can go ahead and click into the second bullet point. And again, I'm going to add another image in there. And I'm going to add another heading. This is the second item. And then I can also do that to a third one. Okay, so now I have three list items, three bullet points in my list, and each one has an image and a heading in it. Now I can do a lot of things here. So when you click on a list item, so right now I'm clicking on the image, and I can jump up to the list item itself. Inside the list item, you have right now in the toolbar two options. You have the ability to jump to the main settings of the block, or you have the ability to add another list item right from here. So instead of looking for, you know, the right place to hover between two list items and finding this plus button there, you can just click on whichever block you want to add the next item after and find it and click on the toolbar plus button right there. So if I want to add a brand new second list item, I can just click on the plus button right here, and there you go, it's added a new list item, new bullet point, after the very first one. So I can add something in here as well. Okay, this is a small one. And I can add another heading. And now we have four. So once again, if you were to click on the list item and you're like, oh, okay, I want to look at the main settings of the entire list, not the list item, but the entire list, you can just click on settings right here or click on the main parent icon right here as well. So if I just click on settings like this, what it does is it just focuses on the whole list. You can see the entire list is selected right now, and it shows me the settings available to me there. So the very first is, of course, the alignment. You can have none, or in the theme that I'm using, I have the option to use wide or full width or align left or align center or align right. This will be controlled by your theme. So if your theme allows alignments, and which alignments it allows will appear here for you. So just go back to none for now. Then I can choose the list style. So right now it's bullet points, but you can also choose ordered list. Now it's 1, 2, 3, 4. Or you can choose no marker at all. And now you see the bullet points are gone, but this is still semantically a list, okay? The next thing that you can do is you can change the orientation. Now in the toolbar, you're gonna see just the arrows, but here in the inspector on the side, you're gonna notice that we have orientation as the label. So what this means is, do you want it to be vertical? So one list item after another in a single column, or do you want the list items to wrap? So they'll be beside each other and then go onto a different row as space permits, right? So right now, if I press horizontal, you'll notice nothing actually happened. But here in the inspector, there is a brand new field called sub item max width. So here it's saying, hey, each list item right now has a max width of 350 pixels. So it's gonna spread to be a maximum of 350 pixels whenever it can. If I make this smaller, 100, now you can see it doesn't let it get bigger than 100 pixels, so more of them are able to fit on a single row. You also can change which unit you choose your max width in. So there's pixels, but you can also choose percentage or EM, REM, viewport width, viewport height. So choose the one that you are most comfortable with, the one that you understand and makes sense for you. The block makes it all available, but which units you see may be impacted by the theme that you're using. So I'm gonna say, let's see, percentage. Now, I don't want to be 100%, but maybe I want it to be 50%. And then I want it to be wide width here. So right now that's still a little too big. So I could choose 30%. Oh, and now three of them fit on a single row. But I actually want two in each row, so I can kind of play around with the numbers and see what works best for me. And I'm also gonna go ahead and make this image a little bit bigger. There we go. And now you can see we have a grid basically of four list items. Now, if your theme allows, you'll also notice that there are color and dimension controls available for you per list item and for the entire list. So I can choose to make the background color of the entire list. Let's say this, that's the text color, the green. There we go. And I wanna make all the text white, but I don't like that it's touching the edges here. So I'm gonna add some padding using the dimensions area to the entire list. Now I'm gonna choose rem, make it 1. And now there's a little bit of space around all of them, except this one, which is coming out. Kind of just want it to be full. It's a bad image. Let's change this image. Okay, this is a better image. All right, so we've added a little spacing, but now you can also go ahead and go into, let's say, the second list item and select that. And I can change the background color of this one to something else if I want. Let's go with this peach color. And then I can change the text color to be this green. But I also want some spacing around this one so the text isn't touching the edges. So I can go into dimensions for just this list item. Go to padding. Once again, add some padding here too. And now you can see I've added some padding to this one only. And it's responsive, right? So I can preview this in tablet mode, looks like that. And then in mobile mode, it goes to single column because now they can't fit all into, like two can't fit on a single row. And it just sort of intuitively does this based on that one max width setting that you set. So that is all the possibilities that you have with the Superlist block. If you have any questions, please don't hesitate to ask in the GitHub repo or in the WordPress support forum for the plugin, and I will be happy to answer any questions that you might have.